Hello friends, this video will be about the various types of commonly used harmonicas. So in response to my previous video, I had received many requests from various beginners to just clarify the difference among various types of harmonicas that are available in the market and to guide them which harmonica to buy. I will also discuss very briefly a few tips for maintenance of harmonica. So first let us talk about the various types of harmonicas that are commonly used in music. So basically all the harmonicas, most commonly they can be categorized into three different groups. So these three groups are tremolo, diatonic and chromatic. So the basic structure of all the harmonicas, basic principle of all the harmonicas is same. That is, all these harmonicas, they are the wind instruments and they have the reeds. So what is the difference? So first let me discuss about the diatonic harmonica. So as it is clear from the name, since it is a diatonic harmonica, as I had previously discussed in one of my lessons, this diatonic harmonica only contains the shuddh swars. That is, it do not contain any tivra or komal swar, no chromatic note. So that's why this is called diatonic harmonica. So most commonly used diatonic harmonicas are the 10 hole harmonicas. So in Europe, you will find some of the customized harmonica in which they use some chromatic note also. That is, apart from using all the shuddh swars, they can use some tivra or komal swar. So that is the tailor-made harmonica. So but mostly this diatonic harmonica contains all the shuddh swars. So these are some of the diatonic harmonicas in different keys. This is a puck, which is a short form of harmonica, and this is the smallest harmonica which is available. Basically this is a four hole harmonica. Now I come to the second category, that is tremolo. So what is the difference between diatonic and tremolo? The tremolo may be a diatonic harmonica or a tremolo may be a chromatic harmonica also, like SCT-128 Suzuki. So that is a chromatic tremolo. So in tremolo, what you will see that a single hole, single note contains two holes, one above the other. So in both these holes, for the same note, there are two reeds. Like if we talk about the tuning, the A4 note, that has the standard tuning of 440 Hertz. So in this case, if we talk about the A4 note, so that A4 note, it will have two reeds. So one reed is above, the second is below, and both these reeds, they are slightly offset from the normal 440 Hertz tuning. So it means that one reed will have slightly higher tuning, okay, or it will be, you can say, slightly sharpened, and second reed will be slightly flattened. So when you blow or draw that particular two holes, so both the reeds, they will vibrate, and because of the slight frequency difference, one phenomena that most of us have studied in physics, that is beats. So beats are produced. So what is beat? Beat is that we do not have a continuous sound, but because of the slight frequency difference, we obtain the slight wavering sound. That is beat. So I will just explain it. So this natural vibrato effect that you will get in case of tremolo. It will not be a plain note, but instead of that, you will get a wavering sound. Now next I come to the chromatic category, which is the most commonly used harmonicas in India. So you will see that all the chromatic harmonicas, they contain this button that is called slider. So in chromatic category, the most common is the 12 hole harmonica that contains 12 holes or 3 octaves. So if you want to have a larger coverage, then you can have the 16 hole harmonica. The extra 4 holes, they give you one extra octave. So this 16 hole harmonica, it has 4 octaves. So apart from that, very common category is the 24 hole, like Suzuki Songstar or this one, Tower. So these are 24 hole harmonicas, but they are very much similar to our normal 12 hole. Why? Because in 12 hole, in one hole, you have 4 reeds, 2 for blow note, 2 for draw note. Okay, 2 blow means one for the normal slider condition, second for the slider press. Similarly, 2 draw, one for the normal slider, other for the slider pressed. In case of 24 hole, in one hole, you have only 2 reeds. One for slider out, second one for slider in. So the second hole is for the blow notes. Blow with normal slider, blow with slider in. So in chromatic notes, you get all the Shuddh Swars, you get all the Tivras and Komal. So that is the main thing. You get all the notes in case of the chromatic harmonica. Whereas in diatonic, you do not get all the notes. If you want to create all the notes, then you have to do the bending. So that we will discuss later on. So I think this different categories of harmonicas is clear to you. Now I received the request for tip for buying the harmonica. So my suggestion is, the very first consideration is the budget. The basic chromatic harmonica starts from 400 rupees and you can get a chromatic harmonica that is as much as expensive as 3 lakh rupees. So it is basically all depends all upon your budget. So the basic very simple harmonica is the Tower. So I always recommend the beginners to purchase this basic harmonica Tower, which is 24 hole harmonica. You can get it for 400 or 450 rupees. Once you are fluent in playing the harmonica, then you can go for the higher models. Now about the basic tips of maintenance. So I do not recommend to the beginners to open the harmonica, but with the basic maintenance, what you can do, you can increase the life of the harmonica. So what I do, now this is a simple mouthwash. You can take any clean cloth and you can just clean the mouthpiece of the harmonica with this mouthwash after every play. So that will increase the life of the harmonica. And secondly, you can use these earbuds for cleaning the slider part of the harmonica gently, very gently. You have to be careful that you do not leave this cotton part in the hole. So you can just clean the slider part and then slider press position. Just clean very gently. So that will increase the life of the slider. And whenever you are going to give a performance on any valved harmonica, so be careful that you bring the temperature of the harmonica at the room temperature, because when you have moisture in the weather or you have very low temperature weather, so in that case sometimes some of the valves, they may stick to the reeds. So in that case, what you can do, you can just warm the harmonica by placing it in your hand or by putting it in your pocket or by just rubbing it in your hands for some time. Okay. Secondly, you can use the heating pad also. You can also use the hair dryer, but be careful. Do not throw directly the air into the reeds. So this heating pad I recommend, you just heat it and place the harmonica for some time, say 10 to 15 minutes, so that it gets warm and it gets into the playable condition. So I hope these basic brief tips might be helpful for the beginners for playing harmonica, and I will be posting some of such tips very regularly. Thank you for now.